This video will give an overview of dialysis treatments for babies diagnosed with kidney disease before birth and babies who might be born with kidney failure. Kidneys are important because they clean the blood to keep salts like sodium, potassium, and calcium at safe levels, remove waste products by making pee or urine, keep the body's fluid levels balanced by either getting rid of extra water or helping the body make less pee when needed, help keep blood pressure and hormones in a steady state, and control how the body makes red blood cells. For babies born with severe kidney disease, the kidneys might not work. Depending on the baby's size and overall health, especially the health of the heart and lungs, dialysis might be an option. There are two types of dialysis, peritoneal dialysis and hemodialysis. In peritoneal dialysis, or PD, dialysis fluid, called dialysate, is put into the belly through a soft tube called a PD catheter. This PD catheter is placed by a surgeon in the operating room. The fluid stays in the belly for a while, where the thin lining of the belly, the peritoneal membrane, acts as a filter, pulling waste, toxins, and extra fluid from the blood into the dialysis fluid. After 30 to 60 minutes, the used fluid, now full of waste, is drained out and replaced with fresh dialysate. This process is filling the belly with dialysate fluid, allowing the fluid to stay, or dwell, in the belly, and then draining the fluid out of the belly is called a cycle. For newborns, this process is done manually by a nurse. Manual PD is done continuously, and babies typically need 24 to 32 of these cycles in a day. Babies start manual PD with small volumes of dialysate in the belly, often 20 to 30 ml, or about 1 ounce, and gradually increase the amount of dialysate fluid over many weeks until the fill volume reaches 120 ml, or 4 ounces. At this time, the baby can switch to a PD machine called a cycler, which can be used while the child is sleeping. PD cyclers can be used at home or in the hospital. Families are trained in how to manage everything related to the PD cycler before going home. Babies who leave the hospital on PD will need PD treatments every night, with each treatment lasting 10 to 16 hours, depending on the needs of the patient. During hemodialysis, a large IV tube called a hemodialysis catheter is inserted into a large blood vessel in the neck or chest and fed into the heart. This catheter is placed in the operating room. During a hemodialysis treatment, this catheter is connected to a hemodialysis machine. The machine pumps blood into a filter outside the body where dialysis fluid cleans the blood of toxins and removes excess fluid from the body. The used dialysis fluid, now containing toxins, waste, and any excess fluid removed from the body, is drained, and the clean blood is returned to the patient. There are different types of hemodialysis machines, with the major differences being how slowly versus quickly the blood is cleaned and the excess body fluid removed. Continuous hemodialysis machines, also called CRRT machines, provide dialysis over long periods of time, anywhere from 6 to 24 hours per day. CRRT machines are only used in intensive care units, or ICU. In contrast, intermittent hemodialysis machines clean the blood and remove excess body fluid over 3 to 4 hours. Intermittent hemodialysis machines can be used both in an outpatient clinic setting or during the inpatient hospital stays, including outside of an ICU. Babies on hemodialysis may need multiple treatments per week to stay healthy. The choice of dialysis therapy, manual PD, PD cycler, CRRT, or intermittent hemodialysis depends on the patient's medical needs, how big the patient is, how strong a patient's heart and lungs are, and the experience of the ICU and nephrology teams. Babies born with kidney failure will need dialysis until they are healthy and big enough to have a kidney transplant and receive an adult-sized kidney, typically about 2 years, but maybe longer. It is very common for babies to start with one form of dialysis treatment and then switch to another form of dialysis for different reasons. These switches of dialysis therapy can happen both during the initial hospitalization but also anytime up until the time of kidney transplant. With the right care and treatment, many infants born with kidney failure will live healthy and happy lives. Your care team is here to support you and your baby every step of the way. We hope this video helps with your fetal consultation. It is not meant to replace a consultation with a pediatric nephrologist.